Hello and welcome to the VGA podcast. It's Caleb and Alex back with you again this week with episode 44. So good morning, Alex. You excited to talk about some Rings of Power?
I'm actually very excited because I'm so conflicted on this show. So I'm excited to delve into your thoughts.
Yeah, I'm kind of, I don't know if conflicted is the right term, but yeah, we'll definitely have a lot to talk about, I think. I guess, yeah, conflicted is, yeah, we'll talk about it.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about Rings of Power. We'll talk about both season one a little bit and then more season two because that's the more recent one. And then we'll get into a video game music trivia quiz, as well as play Guess the Game, and then just talk about whatever else we've been watching or playing this week. So let's go ahead and get on into it. Let's talk about the Rings of Power. So we both watched season one and season two. Just for a little background, I watched like the first five episodes of season one when it first came out and then dropped it and then went back. And right before season two came out, watched all of season one and then watched season two, which might have been a mistake, but we'll talk about that too. and you, I think you're kind of similar. You watched a few episodes of season one, is that right? When it first came out?
I think I watched like, when it first came out, watched three or four, maybe.
Okay.
And stopped.
Yeah, so we'll talk a little bit about season one and then dive more deeply into season two because it's the more recent one. But yeah, so we'll do no spoilers first. We'll give our thoughts on the seasons and give overall scores, and then we'll give a spoiler warning before we get into spoilers. So, Alex, you want to tell us what you thought about season one of Rings of Power?
Sure, yeah. Season one, I'm still conflicted because there's things I like more and things I like less about season one. And I think I like season two more, but I also think season two kind of has more problems in a way.
Yeah.
But I would give season one probably a 4. I think it's below average. I think I could even go 3, to be honest. I think it's 8 episodes is total, and the first 4 or 5 episodes are just a drag.
Yeah.
And not even like a good build-up drag. It's just, I feel like the pacing is off. I feel like it's a little confusing in a sense of just where everything's kind of going, like motivations. Like I don't know. And it picked up a little bit towards the end. I did like the last couple episodes, but maybe it's just because something was happening. yeah, season one, not my favorite, and I don't know, man. It just I can't grasp what it is, and I'm not, and kind of to preface this, like I am not a huge like Lord of the Rings, like I've never read the books. I love Lord of the Rings, like the movie, the original trilogy.
Mm-hmm.
Like I haven't read the book, so I know there's a lot of book readers and stuff that, you know, are 100% against this because it's just not correct. So just keep in mind, I don't think you've read the book either, or have.
I've read the Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit back in high school, but it's been a long time. But I haven't read any of the other stuff, none of the Silmarillion or anything, so I don't really have that background.
So just keep in mind, like, I might say things that, you know, book readers will say is, you know, wrong, like in the show, but I just don't know about that. So I'm basing this straight up with the show, not the comparing it to books or nothing. But even then, 3 out of 10 for the first season. 3 or 4, I should say. I think I said 4 at first, but
yeah, you did.
I'm telling myself 3 now.
You're trying to steal my score. Yeah, because my score for season 1 is a 3. I think it shows that it took both of us who both loved the original Lord of the Rings trilogy. It took us 2 tries to get through season 1. That's not great. It's kind of a mess. The writing is weird. The characters, I don't feel like, are handled very well. Like the time scale of things is weird, and I think it gets worse in season 2, where sometimes it feels like it takes months to get from place to place, but then other times they get there in like a day, and it's just like, what?
That was one of my biggest complaints in season 2.
Yeah, so like, yeah, there are some characters that I like more than others and some stories that I like a little bit more than others. Like some of those character plot points that they're going with are just like such a drag that if any of them show up in an episode, you're like, oh man, this is about to slow way down. But yeah,
that Harfoot scene.
Yeah, the Harfoots. Exactly. I thought there were a couple things I liked in season one. I really liked seeing the like Durin and Elrond. I mean, it's been out for a while, so we can like kind of spoil some things. Like the Durin and Elrond like friendship was really interesting, and I thought that was done pretty well.
Yeah, I like that. That was a positive.
Yeah, I also like Durin and his wife. Why can't I think of her name? Like, I think that's an interesting dynamic that they have.
It's not lore accurate, bro.
Yeah, I know. That's fine. Hey, if something's good in this show, even if it's not lore accurate, I'm like, okay, please give me something good. Like, and I'm not saying it's like great, but it's better than the rest of the show. But like how they handled Galadriel, I'm not a big fan of. And like, I don't know. And is it just me or is this show like extra cheesy at times?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Almost like its purpose, is it not? Maybe it's not.
I don't know. I don't think it's supposed to be, but man,
but it feels like it should be.
Yeah, some of the lines are like, oh, man, it's like you should have spiked the camera lens when you said that kind of cheese. but yeah, I did not think season one was good, and I think it shows that we, who should be loving this show, couldn't even get through season one the first time. So
sure, it's been what, 2-3 years since season one came out?
Yeah,
we used to have marathons all the time of Lord of the Rings.
Yep, extended edition. You're right,
and that's saying we couldn't even finish it the first time we watched it. Yeah, like, that is saying something. I didn't think. What about season two? So wait, what was your score?
A 3. So now season two, I'm a little conflicted on. I'll go ahead and start since you started on season one.
Okay.
I think there are things that season two did better. But yeah, there's just some really weird stuff. They focused on parts that, one, weren't that interesting in season one, but then two, they made it way worse. I'm between a 3 and a 4. I think there's one thing in season two that I think makes it better. And if they would have focused on it more and done a few things differently, I think it could have been good. But I guess I'll go with a 4, although I'm between a 3 or 4. So I still think it was below average. The writing is not great. All the characters do weird things to make the plot work. And it's really cheesy. I felt like season two was even cheesier than season one in some parts.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it also, they spent so much money on the show and it just doesn't feel like it.
No. Well, there's moments I feel like it does.
There are moments where I could see it, but like, it's just kind of ruined by the fact that there's no real weight behind it because the story is just so, lackluster. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I gave it a 4. Okay. Yeah.
I think I'm similar to you. So I enjoyed this season more. This is where, when I said I was conflicted, I am conflicted too, because it was season 2 mostly. Because I do think I enjoyed it more in the sense of it wasn't as boring.
Yeah.
For me, it wasn't. Like, I was actually watching it pretty quick. I'm like, okay, I'll keep watching. But there's other stuff that made me kind of more mad or just confused, which we can get into spoilers, because there is a lot. And I was thinking this while I was watching the show, and it was distracting me. Like, that's how much I was thinking about it, which is bad in the show.
Yeah.
And it's like you said, just the time. Like, I can't figure out time in this world. I really can't. Like, to the point where I was so confused. Like, how is this happening? There's a whole plot line, which I think this is what you're saying, hinting at. Like, I actually enjoyed elements of it, but there are some parts that are so stupid. This season, I think the difference is this season pisses me off more, but season one's just more boring. So what do I like more?
That's an interesting way to put it. Yeah.
I think I still like season two more just because there is pretty good action. The last couple episodes, while some stuff ruins it, at least was kind of cool. Like, it kind of felt like Lord of the Rings, you know, like, kind of.
Yeah.
But then there's parts of that where it just pissed me off too, which we can get in. Okay. I'm going to say four. The first one, I dropped down to three because I talked myself into it, and this one was a four.
Okay. Yeah. So we're pretty. Yeah,
I just can't get into more. I can't get into more without spoiling things. That the more I'm talking about it, see, this is what happens with me is I kind of enjoy it a little bit while I'm watching it, and I start talking to you about it, and I start realizing, wait a second.
Yeah, like when you start to think about something deeper and stuff doesn't make sense, there's issues there for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, we just need to get in spoilers. So honestly, the show's both of our views below average.
Yeah. And like,
I think the second season was watchable, at least.
Yeah.
If you want to get pissed off.
I agree that it wasn't as boring, but yeah, there were definitely some issues.
Like, I watched season two faster. I don't know, maybe it's because I was just in the groove of it. But no, that's not true. Because season one, even when I rewatched, season one was boring.
Yeah.
Season two at least could freaking get through. But
that's why I said it was kind of a a mistake to rewatch all of season one. I should have just started the episode I left out off and been a little confused at some things, because man, that made it like it was so boring rewatching it. Like,
yeah, well, maybe you wouldn't be confused because they always start some episodes with characters in random spots, like, how'd you get here?
That's true.
Like, there's some moments I'm like, am I on the right episode?
But oh, that sounds great. All right, yeah, let's get into spoilers. So, spoiler alert for season two of The Rings of Power.
Rings of Power. Yeah. I don't even know where to start.
Let's start with, what do you think was the best thing about season two? Because I have something in mind.
So I think the scenes with Lord Celebrimbor and Sauron, I don't know what they called him.
Annatar. Yeah, so. Annatar and Celebrimbor.
I think.
Yep.
So I think their scenes are the best scenes, but I also think those scenes are one of the most frustrating scenes because I just don't understand. Maybe I'm dumb. I don't understand how no elves like can go and warn this town, or I don't know, like, how far apart is these lands? But it seems like this is where I just don't get. How does no one know, or have been told, or is there no one else in power in that? What's the town, or Arrenor or something like that?
Aragion.
Aragion. Like, I just don't understand.
Yes.
How does no? I don't.
I agree, because even at the beginning of the season, like, it starts with Elrond and Galadriel having a full tilt race to get the rings to, I think it's Aragion, or maybe to Lindon from Aragion, and so it makes it seem like, oh yeah, they can just like sprint there, so it seems pretty close, and then
Galadriel knows. She knows. Why didn't she just go spout it to the world? Why is she so secretive about this crap?
Well, and the thing is, like, she told Celebrimbor, don't trust Halbrand. And then he trusts Halbrand. And like, yeah, there are just some things where it's like, wait, why is he going along with
this? He did say, like, I think I knew deep down, but I was just, you know, enthralled with this lust kind of thing.
Yeah.
But the biggest thing for me is, I feel like this show, why did they have Galadriel? No, they should have had her just have suspicions and everything. That would have at least explained how no one's like,
yeah, that's
like,
true.
Our complaint, how no one knows, like, why isn't she sending troops and armies there? Like, what's, you know, like, at least that if she didn't know when she had suspicions, people could just be like, no, you're crazy. Look at him. He's such a nice guy. He's helping us out.
Yeah.
He's the Lord of Gifts.
It would
what
have made
talking about?
More so sense for sure.
Yeah, and I don't get the time lapse. Like, how long does it take to get between these
Lindon and Aragion, or Aragion and Khazad Dûm? Yeah, it seems like the writers needed to.
Khazad Dûm, like, the dwarves travel there like two episodes, like nothing. Oh, the rings is making my dad go crazy.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm back in Khazad Dûm.
Yeah.
Or like even What's his face? Elrond. He's like randomly goes to Khazad, at least in the first season. It doesn't seem like it's that far. And if he can get there that fast, and people there can get to, what's Linden, it called? That town?
Lindon?
Yeah. Or no, the one where Sauron's at.
Aragion.
Yeah, Aragion. If the dwarves can get there fast, and Elrond can get to Khazad Dûm fast, then shouldn't it be like, shouldn't we go straight to Aragion to warn about Sauron?
Yeah. And at one point, like, Elrond and a group of elves, like, leaves Lindon to go to Aragion, and they're just, like, walking through the forest all chill. It's like, you guys couldn't have taken horses, or, like, I mean, you raced that path against Galadriel. You obviously can take horses. Like, I don't know. And then they get blocked by the bridge being broken. And it's like, okay, this whole timeline is weird.
I don't get it. I don't get it. Cause, and Galadriel knows that he's Sauron. Why isn't she like, we need to get there fast, guys. Like, let's freaking go.
Yeah.
Like, I know she's a little corrupted by the ring, maybe. I just don't. Not corrupted,
by the deceiver. Like, they made it a point multiple times that once you've been deceived by Sauron, you basically can't trust yourself. And you could always be corrupted again.
And then, was there supposed to be some, like, romance between Sauron and Galadriel?
Kind of felt like they were, hinting at that. Which I do not care for.
No, and again, this is lore breaking. Because Galadriel was supposed to have like a husband and kid at this point, I think, from what I've read.
Celeborn, I think, yeah.
Yeah. Which, isn't he? He's like an important character, isn't he?
I think so, yeah. From what I remember.
Her husband?
Yeah. He's there in the movies in Lothlorien, I think.
Yeah, and I read somewhere that showrunners are bringing him into the show.
Okay.
But like, it's going to be season 3. How is he not in the show yet?
Yeah. I don't know.
But anyways, taking away even lore crap, it's still...
I feel like this show makes me appreciate Lord of the Rings because, like, they make this world feel so small.
Yeah.
Like, in Lord of the Rings, it's like this expansive place and there's so many things and so many characters and even just, like, so many, like, side actors and... But this one, there's like...
Oh, it's a journey, man.
Yeah.
It's
like... And it takes them forever to get places, and it shows the journey. But in this one, it's like there are two towns with like two sets. There's like three background actors in each place. Like it feels so tiny.
As much as I love the Sauron and Celebrimbor scenes, it's all in the tower. Like I felt like I'm watching a TV show. Like this is just, well, it is a TV show, but like a cheap TV show.
Yeah.
Not the most expensive TV show ever. Like it's literally... Where's that? I know nothing about that town when it fell. Nothing
Aragion about it. Was like two sets. It was like inside the tower and then just outside the tower. And then everything else was like CG.
Like how are we supposed to feel like shots. Bad or anything with the battle at the end, you know? Like,
yeah.
Ugh,
I do think so Celebrimbor there were some parts where I felt genuinely bad for him. Like,
oh, he had it the worst, man.
Yeah. And his actor was good. I felt like his actor did. Probably one of the best jobs.
I liked him. Mm-hmm.
I
thought he was the best too, and I thought the acting was good. And I thought like his story, I actually did feel kind of tragic. Like God, like he's being deceived, almost prisoner. Like it was kind of scary. Like that's the first time I felt Sauron is scary in a sense of not just like a monster. You know, he's like trapping this guy.
Yep.
Which to me is terrifying.
That is, yeah. He did some pretty messed up stuff to Celebrimbor.
Like, homeboy, like, pretty much lost his mind.
Yep.
There
was one thing they did with that, though, that I think could have made it so much better. So this is getting a little bit into the lore that I've just, like, read about online and stuff, but it makes total sense, and I have no idea why they changed it. Why did they make the elves' rings first? Because in the lore, they make... the humans and the dwarves, and then Celebrimbor like makes the elves on his own and then keeps it from Sauron, and that's why he freaks out. And like it just would have made so much more sense. I don't get why they had to change that. And like the elves are the only ones not corrupted, so it makes sense that Sauron would have the least amount of like influence on those. And yeah, it's just
Because he didn't finish the rings with them, right?
Yeah,
he
because
left before they finished the rings.
Right. And like when she's like, when Galadriel's like taking the Rings of Men away, we know as an audience, if you watch Lord of the Rings, like Sauron gets those. We know that.
Yeah.
Like we know how this is going to end. But if it was the elf ones, we wouldn't have known that. Yeah. And we would have been left in way more suspense. Like I just don't understand it.
You hit on it now. There's like the suspense with some of the characters we obviously know live.
Yeah,
but you could still make it suspenseful.
Yeah, true. They did do some like, oh, is Galadriel gonna die? And I'm like, well, obviously no.
Yeah. Like, oh, I was so shocked. Like, God, she's dead. Yeah, there's zero suspense in that fight.
Yeah,
zero suspense.
Yeah, that fight was not great.
But I know we've talked negative, but there are some things I like. Like, I thought the first episode, actually, I think it was the very first scene, was pretty cool, showing. After Sauron got like betrayed and stabbed by all the orcs and his like little whatever the heck he is.
The symbiote Sauron.
pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Just kind of going around and attached. Yeah. I thought that was kind of like cool. Like it was, I don't know, I thought it was pretty creepy cool. I thought, like I said, I thought some of the action was cool. Mm-hmm. As pointless as his character is, what's that elf's name?
Celebrimbor? Or no, which,
Arondir? Arondir?
Yeah.
As pointless as I think he is, I thought his fight scene, like, he's a cool fighter. Like, he's pretty cool in the sense of just, like, kind of like a, he almost feels like a rogue elf, to be honest.
Yeah, I agree.
I thought the best scenes were probably, like you said, the dwarves and Khazad Dûm or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I thought, and at least their storyline connected to the Rings of Power, unlike some of the other storylines.
Yeah. Definitely.
I'm trying to think of more positive. I thought some of the battle was cool at the end. Like, it was kind of cool for moments and ruined by other moments.
Yeah. Like, episode 7. Like, the build-up
was kind of cool.
Had some cool fight scenes. It had flashes, but yeah. There were definitely some things that ruined it, but.
Yeah, but definitely, like, there's definitely moments that I was like, okay, this is cool, finally, we're getting something that feels like Lord of the Rings, like, kind of, randomly, in, like, a minute increment.
Mm-hmm. Some of the reveals of, like, how Annatar or Sauron was, like, manipulating Celebrimbor, like, when you find out he's in an illusion and it, like, all fades away, that was a cool moment. Like, there were some cool...
You can even see like something like a monster in flames. I don't know if you caught that in one of the episodes.
Yeah, the Balrog, I think.
Sauron. There's a scene where like after I think it was after that lady elf was being deceived,
okay,
or she put on the ring, and she saw like a monster or whatever. Obviously, it was Sauron, and it shows. She's standing next to like a flame, and for a split second, you could see like a monster, or like I think it's like Sauron's true form or something.
Oh, yeah.
I'm about to find that scene for you.
Yeah, I'm not sure I caught that.
I caught that, and I was like, okay, that was kind of cool. It was like a split second.
Yeah.
Like, you could have literally looked down for a second and missed it.
Yeah, possibly what happened.
I thought the Sauron scenes were pretty good. I'm trying to think of more positives.
Okay, let's talk about the best part of this whole series. What do you think about the Stranger and his eventual...
I don't know, the fact we hardly brought this stuff up.
The reveal. The Grand Elf.
So I think two things, and you hit on a nail. I think I just don't understand the scope of this, because in season one, you know, they're at the very end, you know, the Stranger and freaking Frodo wannabe. She's like, we're going on an adventure. We're gonna travel these lands. And like season two is just desert and going in circles.
Yeah.
And then they split up, and he finds what's his name, Tom or whatever. Which I actually did Tom like those scenes. Those are actually some scenes I did like too. Actually,
it's interesting. There were some interesting parts, but he didn't feel like Tom Bombadil to me. But
no, well, I don't. Yeah, like, I have almost no knowledge of it.
Right.
So like for me, he was at least a character that was kind of interesting.
Yeah.
And I liked the little song. but yeah, no, that's we all know he's freaking Gandalf. Like, come on, you don't have to build suspense for two seasons.
Yeah.
My lord.
That was silly.
Isn't it obvious? Especially at the beginning of the season when those things were like, oh, it's the other wizard. It's not Saruman. Like, okay. Well, clearly. Why don't you just say the name there?
Yeah. I don't get that. It dragged on forever. And like.
And why are the Harfoots in this? I don't get it. Are they just trying to throw in hobbits to find. To find the Shire, or just to make us happy, or what?
Yeah, it kind of seems like they just wanted more connections to the movies, so they threw in
because it's literally hobbits. Frodo and Sam,
yeah,
in female version, like literally. She even looks like a girl version of Frodo.
Yeah, and a girl version of Sam, and the Sam wannabe even had a Sam like quote, inspirational quote at the end of the season, just like Sam does.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Right. Yeah, what's her name? Poppy, right? Is it Poppy?
Yes, yeah, because it's
Nori and Poppy.
Yep.
Yeah. I think they're just trying to like you're right. Like they're gonna find like the Shire, right? That's gonna be like the lands they're talking about.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But my thing is, what does that have to do with the Rings of Power?
Yeah, it doesn't. I think the main thing they're trying to do is show why Gandalf likes hobbits, maybe. Like, if I were to make an argument for it, I would say, like, he has a very soft spot for hobbits, and this makes sense why, but it's not worth two seasons of dragging us through boring scenes.
Well, and, like, does Gandalf, do they need to even be in the show? Do they have anything with the actual Rings of Power until later on?
Yeah, not yet.
I don't know the books or anything, but, like, do they have any important plot points for at this point in time in the lore?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Because, I mean, obviously they get involved eventually, clearly, like you've seen the movies.
Yeah.
But like, up until this point, like, what about they weren't like in the battle, you know, at the beginning of Lord of the Rings, you know, what's that battle? That the one that showed at the very beginning?
Yeah. I forget the name of it, but the one
where Sauron gets his. Yeah, or Sauron gets us that where their whole ring thing. Like, they're not there, so, like, do they have anything up to this point?
No idea.
I don't know. I'm curious. If you know in the comments, let us know, because we clearly. But it doesn't feel like it's connected right now. It just feels like they're trying to be like, oh, look, it's Gandalf. Oh, look, these are hobbits that aren't quite hobbits yet, and they're going to find the Shire.
Yep.
Like, and so I think that storyline's completely pointless, and every time that storyline came on, I knew it was going to drag.
Yep.
Oh, you got the staff chooses you. Oh, look at Tom's wearing Gandalf's hat. He's pretty eventually going to get.
There was that part where he's like, the staff chooses you. It felt so Harry Potter. I was expecting Tom to go like, you're a wizard, Gandalf.
I just don't. I just. And then they found those little hobbits. I don't even know what they're called in the desert area. And it's like
stores or something. Yeah.
Stores, yeah. I just none of that was interesting to me. It's like, and then Poppy too, but Nori and Gandalf go their separate ways. It's like, what was the point of going on this dang adventure?
Also, yeah, if, at like, the beginning,
you didn't do anything.
The same thing kind of happened. Like, they split off from Poppy, and then Poppy just shows back up again in episode one. It's like, what is the point?
I thought, didn't she just say like she's coming to check on him or something?
Yeah,
I thought, and then she just stays. She never said, like, oh, I came to join you on your journey. She's just like, oh, I just came to check how you're doing.
<It's> so silly.
And also, like, again, the time. Like, haven't they been walking for a while? How'd she catch up? I know she's a navigator or whatever, but I don't know. And I guess they're lost in the desert. I don't know. It just feels so small.
Yeah,
like
it really does.
They were going to go on this grand adventure, and they just were in this desert spinning around for half the episodes and split up half the episodes.
Yeah. So there's one more thing that I thought got ruined even more in season two than in season one, and we haven't even talked about it. Do you know what I'm talking about?
One more thing that got ruined.
Like, big storyline.
Is it is it the other main storyline they try to focus on?
Yeah, and we haven't talked about it once.
Out of Middle Earth? Yeah.
Yeah, the Numenoreans. What happened there? They turned Numenor from like this beautiful, majestic place to just a place filled with a bunch of assholes. Oh my goodness.
I don't know. They just like, you're right. Like, I don't, that story, like, the whole storyline just flipped.
Yeah, like they made R. Farazone and his son just so unlikable.
Why did they do that? Was there like, the actress, were some people not available or something? Because it just seemed like it flipped a switch. Like, was the queen lady just not, like, because she's not being a lot of episodes, so like, oh, we got to make some conflict here. I don't know. It just fell off.
Yeah, I felt like the weakest episode was episode 3 of season 2, where they focused a lot on Numenor, and it was that episode where, like...
Yeah.
Okay, can you explain to me what happened with that giant eagle that apparently made Farazon king? Like, that just showed up there, and they're like, oh, that means I'm king. And it's like, what? Oh, okay.
I knew they were setting that up, too, because, you know, earlier, like, oh, it's so rare, the eagle's not going to show up.
Yeah.
In eons or whatever. But I don't understand how he just happened to walk up to the eagle. What if someone else walked up to the eagle?
I know. It's so weird.
It's not like eagle like came up to him and like freaking yapped at him.
It's at Muriel's coronation. Wouldn't that make it showing up even more proof that she should be queen?
To like, her?
What
if she was standing at the balcony? Would she have been the one that everyone's like, oh, she's the chosen one?
And then she survives that sea monster thing, so they're all like, oh yay, she's queen again. Mm-hmm. And then Farazon shows one dude one piece of paper and he just goes, Sauron, and then she's not queen again. Like, what proof does he have? Just a piece of paper that says Sauron?
I feel like this whole I don't get this either, because I like, where is this going? Because they the son, which that dude, that was one scene I actually was surprised by, because he's like, at least he's not a character, he's a new character, you know, is that the captain kid, the guy that's super loyal to the queen, and the kid stabbed him, son stabbed him.
Yep.
I was actually shocked by that scene.
Yeah.
And I actually thought that was like a more intense scene, but it's because it's the characters we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually, as much as like he didn't do anything, I actually kind of liked him. Probably because he's like only the one like on that storyline that's loyal and
cool has some redeeming qualities. Yeah.
Yeah. So like I was actually shocked by that death. And but I think it's more so it's like, why are you killing one of the few characters I like in the storyline?
Yeah, true. And like Elendil's daughter got so bad.
Oh, don't get me started on that girl. Oh, my God.
Oh
dude, that's like, it was like just a random bad, too. It's like, holy hell. You turn this a sweet, innocent girl to like, one of my most hated characters in the show.
Yeah. Like, she horrible. Was either really dumb or like really disloyal. It was bad.
She's awful. I do like Captain Elendil. I feel like he's supposed to be, you know, like the, I don't know, like the, what's the character I'm thinking of? He's supposed to be like the, the good.
Like the Rohan King guy? Is that who you're thinking of?
No, Elendil. Oh, no, I'm just comparing him to like, let me look. He's supposed to be... What's the guy from Game of Thrones?
Oh, Ned.
Yeah, he's supposed to kind of be like the Ned.
Yeah,
I feel like. Like, so I like him. I like him, but like at the same time, he didn't get to do much.
Yeah, he's the righteous, like loyal, knows what's right, and follows that.
Yeah, he's gonna like go back to Middle Earth and kind of claim his. Was that the sword that in Return of the King that he grabbed?
Yeah, it's the one that cuts the ring off Sauron's finger, yeah.
Yeah, okay, so
Narsil.
Is he the one who does that? Do you know?
Isildur does.
Isildur, that's right, because he
it's like broken. Yeah, it's like broken. Well, I think Elendil is in that battle. I think
so,
he might die in that battle, maybe. Someone in the comments can let me know if I'm wrong. But then like the sword gets broken, and then when faces him, he like grabs the shard part, or like the blade, the broken blade, and cuts his finger off.
So but he still might be in that fight. I just don't know, like I'm very bad with like the timeline with Game of Thrones, you know. I don't know like who's in that battle, or I don't know a lot of the big
I think the ones we know in that battle are like, I think Gil-galad is in it, Elrond obviously, Isildur and Elendil are like the main ones.
So we could talk about Isildur. So how do you feel about his character? He's such a big part in the you know, doing that, but do you feel like he obviously is the one who cut the finger off, like you said, but in the show, does he feel like such an important character? He doesn't to me.
Not
he got
yet.
A little more focus this season, yeah, which I liked.
I feel like season one, he was way more like whiny and I didn't really care about mm-hmm. him. This, I mean, obviously I know what they're setting him up to do, and like seeing him as younger and kind of not as mature is kind of interesting, but yeah, right now he just like his whole love situation with that wildling woman is like, I don't really care. We didn't even talk that there were Ents in the season. And like, so a lot of his
That's
stuff
right.
is just kind of in the background so far.
Yeah. But I will say, like, I didn't dislike him.
Yeah,
this season.
I agree.
I thought his character definitely improved. Like you said, with the love interest thing, but as far as like a character outside of that.
I did like his talk with Theo about Theo's mom. I thought that was a kind of mm-hmm. touching scene. So
that lady just couldn't be in the season, right? They just randomly kill her off.
Yeah, like, that was confusing, but I read that, she wasn't coming back, so they just killed her off screen.
I figured, because she was such a, like, she was, like, in every episode, I feel like, in the freaking last season.
Yep.
That makes sense. I will say that whole storyline too, which I guess is kind of interconnected with the other storyline. It kind of felt pointless too right now. Like the remain, you know, Isildur and with that. Who are those people? The remaining of the Southland people.
Yeah, the wild men, I think, is who they are.
Yeah,
or the men of the Southlands.
But it kind of felt. It still feels. Disattached to like what does this have to do with the Rings of Power right now?
Yeah, and like
I know you're setting up Isildur and stuff, but still,
I also don't understand. This is just kind of a smaller thing. Like, why did the Numenoreans take Isildur back to Numenor if like his dad's on the mm-hmm. run? I guess his sister's there and kind of in power, so I guess maybe, but like, I don't know, that just seemed weird. I don't know
and
what
also,
they're doing with that.
I mean, I guess he doesn't know his dad's escaped, but I'm like...
Yeah, would you want to go back? I don't know.
I was going
to
say, would you want to go back? Or I thought... I mean, maybe, I guess you do. You don't. I guess you don't. You didn't see what's kind of been going on, but he kind of told you, like, this little scumbag. Like, yeah. But that storyline, you're right, we saw Ents. I mean... I guess kind of interesting, kind of cool.
Yeah.
I guess
they're not Treebeard. I'll say that.
No, Treebeard. That was. What else do we see? We did see what's the thing you mentioned earlier in Khazad Dûm?
The Balrog.
Yeah, the Balrog, which I thought was cool because.
Yeah, I did think it was cool.
I know I was reading that that's not supposed to happen until way later.
That makes sense.
They're kind of fast timing this timeline.
And
to be honest,
go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, to be honest, it's kind of cool, like, just seeing. It's kind of cool, like, the Khazad Dûm is, to me, is the coolest thing part to see because we know it.
Yeah.
And, like, it's kind of cool seeing the Balrog, like, we know this evil's lurking down here. So it's just kind of. It's just kind of eerie, you know?
Yeah, I thought that was also a pretty strong point of the season up until the end. I have a few gripes with the end that I guess we'll talk about now. So,
yeah.
It was, I liked the, like, the tension between Durin and his father, and I thought that was good, and his mm-hmm. father going a little crazy with the rings. Kind of interesting, and it awakening the Balrog, that's interesting. Lore stuff aside, like, yeah, that could be cool. But then, it seems like okay, so the father, Durin, does his, like, jump to fight the Balrog, which, in slow motion, which, mm-hmm. it looked pretty cool, but, I mean, what are you going to do? It seemed like a pretty dumb idea.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Then it doesn't feel like they take the Balrog as a serious threat, because now they're talking about, oh, your brother's going to try and take the throne.
Yeah.
Like, Doran looks at the ring like he kind of wants to use it. And I'm like, wait, you just were going on about how you should never use it. And then no mention of the Balrog. Like, it just, I don't know. It feels like they have to put it on the back burner now because it's supposed to be later. Yeah, I don't know.
If they don't do it, I will say this. If they, you know, this is supposed to be like a 5-season thing. If like the Balrog doesn't come up again and this was just like a cool little thing, like, oh, look, it's the Balrog, and they don't do anything with it, then this is dumb.
Yeah.
Now, if they like actually show the downfall of like Khazad Dûm and stuff, then that would be kind of cool.
Yeah.
But like, you're right though. Like, just because some rocks fell down and sealed the little part of the hole, like, you saw that thing. You think that thing's going to, can like, not
can't get through a
few rocks.
Yeah.
Like, it could, if there's a tiny hole, like, I'm pretty sure it can whip up a bigger hole.
Yeah,
that was weird. I didn't think about that. They never even mentioned the Balrog. Like, did none of them be like, guys, there's like some freaking demon thing down there?
We should be worried.
You guys still want to, yeah, you guys still want to live here? It's like,
yeah, maybe we find a different mountain. Okay.
If I saw it, I'd be like, I'm out. Peace. Yep. It's a different one. Like, that thing, they saw it. Like, they saw the whole demon-looking thing. It's not like they saw a glimpse of it. Like, yeah. They saw that thing. Killed.
Yep.
His father. It looked cool, like you said. Maybe the dad was just, like, so corrupt. He's like, I'm done for. I'm just gonna...
Yeah.
But did he think, like... Like, it wasn't even like he was trying to save his son, because how did he think that was gonna save his son?
I don't know.
He didn't know that was gonna drop the rocks and seal the hole.
Yeah, that was silly.
Or that, how are you supposed to know, like, him clashing with the whip thing is going to cause some big explosion?
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, it looked cool.
I will say, though, it makes me appreciate how good Lord of the Rings looked. Because, like, it looked basically as Lord of the Rings. And it's
and it was in 2001.
Yeah, 23 years later. And they made it look that good in 2001. That's crazy.
It's insane how much Lord of the Rings holds up. I mean, a lot of it is because they actually use extras and special effects, whereas The Hobbits, you know, it's all CGI.
Mm-hmm.
The Hobbits aged obviously worse than Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, Lord of the Rings looks real and gritty and, like, really dirty good. And, yeah, like...
It looks real.
Oh. Yeah, it looks real, yeah. And this, I will say, this, to me, actually kind of looks better than The Hobbit.
Yeah, probably just because
for being a TV show.
Yeah, it might age just as bad. We'll see.
I mean, it probably. I will say some of the battle looked good.
Yeah,
like I could tell they used some extras instead of the CGI orcs. At least they used like actual people in orc suits. You know,
that's true.
Or makeup, because in The Hobbit is all CGI orcs, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
One last thing. I think this is the last thing I'll bring up as something that I wish they would have done better. And it happened a couple times. I wish they would have shown Sauron being manipulative more instead of just the effects of it. And my biggest gripe with that is the orcs turning on Adar. Like, that was so sudden. They've been like, I mean, they call him Adar, father. Like, I feel like we need a little bit more to be like, okay, this whole army is going to turn on him. I need to see that instead of just being like one scene where they finally meet Sauron and then it cuts.
Like, what's your name?
Yeah.
I think he asked him, what's your name? And like, oh, he actually cares. He wants to know my name.
And then he kills
That's
him.
That's all we saw pretty much.
Yeah.
And I actually liked Adar.
Yeah.
I thought they did a good job showing him actually caring. You know, you could see him kind of tearing up when they're burning bodies.
I thought that actor was pretty good.
Like, I thought he was good, and I thought I liked his scenes, a little bit of his scenes he's in. We got to talk about the final battle before we stop, okay. Because there are some things that bothered me.
Yeah, go for it.
Well, one other negative. I know we're talking a lot of negatives, but I just can't help. Maybe this is lore accurate, I don't know, but the whole with the dwarves and his wife's, the whole singing thing was so stupid to me. My god, it looked so cheesy. Like when she was sitting down there, like when she's sitting down there trying to stop him, and then she starts singing. I'm like, what the hell is she trying to do? And some bats go down and scare him away.
Yeah, that was a silly plan too. Like,
I'm like, this is just weird. Again, I don't know. Maybe that is something dwarves do, but it looked cheesy.
Yeah, I agree.
Like, I thought that was so weird, dude. Like, but that was, yeah, that was a little nitpick. But no, so the final two battles. So I thought, I literally just finished this, the other night. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty fresh in my mind. And so the end of episode 6 ended with them, you know, throwing the fireballs, and that was the end of the episode. Like, oh, the battle's going to start. Yeah. And I was pumped. And then the next episode started with
a charge, right?
I think it started with Celebrimbor and Sauron talking.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Which is fine. But so my problem with this battle, it starts off cool, right? You're pumped and everything, but it just feels so, I don't know how to explain it. Disjointed, the way they did it, which I guess part of it is, I think part of it's intentional, because obviously with Celebrimbor in his mind, and I actually really liked those scenes.
Mm-hmm.
Where, like, and that's what I liked with Sauron, is him kind of manipulating him.
Yeah.
Into, like, that's what you can see more of Sauron doing. Like, yep. He was literally playing with his mind and telling him everything's okay, finish these rings, you're fine. And he started to figure out, like, wait a second, I'm in a time loop.
Yep. That's, like, what we needed to see more of, for sure.
Yeah. I thought that was cool. Like, oh, this is interesting. Like, the whole town around him is going crazy, and he goes and walks outside, and it looks like beautiful day, paintings outside, elves are painting. And, like, to me, that's terrifying. Like, that's more terrifying than, like, the battle. Like, I couldn't imagine, like, you're stuck in a time loop, you're being controlled by some whatever Sauron is, like, God.
Yeah.
Like, I thought those scenes were good. And the actual battle was okay. But there was a scene where when Elrond was charging with the elves.
Yeah.
And again, they're about to go into battle, and then they show the orcs show Galadriel, and they just stop. And
yeah.
And it was just, it looked so weird. I'm like,
it did.
This is so epic. We're, like, going into battle, and they just stop, and then they walk into the camp, and they talk, and then they let them walk back out and go back to their army.
Like, just, like, way to kill all the momentum. Yeah.
Yes, I was literally like, yes, finally, we're getting that cool shot where, like, you get, you know, reinforcements are running, they're charging, and then, like, just nothing. And then not only that, like, they walk into the camp and have a full conversation, and then, like, they let them leave.
And then, like, there's that kiss, and then you just know that he gave, I felt like, it's obvious he gave Galadriel something without, and yeah.
I thought all the orcs saw him take that thing off. He wasn't subtle about it.
Yeah, true.
He just grabbed something from his cloak. I'm like, oh, okay. Well, like,
yeah.
And then the orc's like, he has no weapons. Like, did no one see? He turned his body a little bit, but come on.
Yeah, that was silly.
I thought that from that point on, it just killed the battle for me. I'm like, okay, nothing's cool is going to happen, because if they're stopping this epic moment, they're not going to do this epic moment again.
Yeah, and they tried to do, like, one big part of the battle was when the troll showed up, and I just felt like that fell so flat. Like, the troll killed one orc. And
the troll was actually cracking me up. I was laughing.
That's where
you just grab the bodies. And yeah. Wasn't it? Were you? I mean, the way he was grabbing bodies and just talking and stuff, it was cracking me up. I'm like, is this, like, a spoof?
Yeah, that was
pretty. I will say, there was one scene in the battle I thought was really cool. And finally, it was like 30, it was literally 30 seconds after the elf shoots and explodes the thing, and Elrond and the king are fighting. There was, like, no music. It was just them fighting in a battlefield. They didn't cut away for 30 seconds.
Yeah.
And then it stopped. That was the only time in that whole battle I'm like, this feels like Lord of the Rings. I'm seeing Elrond and the king fight. There's no music. It feels gritty. There's chaos. It's not cutting away. And then that was it.
Yep. Yeah, I agree.
Don't even know if you know what scene I'm talking about, but.
No, I do. I remember that. Yeah, that was cool, but it was really short. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, finally, they're showing, like, just the gnome, because I remember Lord of the Rings specifically, you know how they do the freaking battles.
Mm-hmm.
It starts off grand, you know, and then it kind of, you get claustrophobic, and you're with them in the battlefield fighting. There's no music. It's
chaos.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, it's chaos, and I only got that for a second with the battle. And so all these negatives, so I'll say one last thing. All these negatives, all these complaints, and I still gotta admit, like, I was entertained this season. I'm not gonna lie. I know I gave it a 4, which
yeah.
in our scale is almost average. It's right below average. I was still entertained, man. I gotta admit, like, I still wanted to turn on the next episode.
I kind of agree, although I did have a problem. I watched up through episode 7, and then you got, like, sick and weren't watching it, and I was like, yeah, I don't really want to finish this, so I waited, like, a month to watch episode 8.
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
So, yeah, I mean, it was more entertaining than season 1. I'll give it that.
I think it's because I started it right after season 1, and for me, like I said, season 1 was just so boring.
Yeah.
So at least the season, even though things pissed me off, at least I was like, I had some emotion.
Yeah.
There was something, I don't know.
You felt something, yeah.
I felt something, which is better than feeling nothing, like season 1. God, season 1 was so boring. The only cool episode of season 1 is the whole volcano episode exploding. I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah, I agree.
And that's kind of it.
That's pretty much it.
But here's hoping season 3 will be better. But it's not better by now. It's not. Hey, maybe you could pull up Picard. I don't know if you ever watched Picard.
No, I didn't.
First 2 seasons were straight trash. And the 3rd season's like gold. So you never know.
Okay, well, we'll see. I hope so, but yeah, I doubt it. Like, this should
I
be
did
amazing.
Read they got new writers, they have the same showrunners, so I think the higher ups are still the same, so it'll probably be.
Yeah.
You know, the sad part is I do think the action is cool. Like, if they could, I don't know, have better writing.
And make us care a little more. Right. Yeah.
Yeah, make us care a little more. Like, the only character I care about is Elrond, and you obviously. Obviously, we know, like...
He's fine by Lord of the Rings.
Yeah. Yeah, obviously, we know he's fine. But to me, he's my favorite character. I think his actor can sometimes be a little wooden, but I think that's, like, what elves are supposed to be. I like...
Yeah.
I like his character, especially when he's associating with the dwarves. Like, I just love their friendship.
I agree.
I mean,
and Durin.
But he's probably my favorite. Yeah, Durin and him are probably my 2 favorite characters. Which I feel like that always is with Lord of the Rings, so the elf and the...
Yeah, true.
But, and one last thing I'll say, too, is I think, I keep going back to it, but I think you're right, just the scale, like, it feels like we're watching 3 set pieces, like, it feels so small.
Yeah, it really does.
Like, and it just baffles me, because you're right, when we watch Lord of the Rings, like, my God, it felt exhausting watching, in a good way, like, these... You're happy they finally made it to Mordor, and
after so long, Riven. Yeah,
yes, after so long, like you could feel the journey, man. And this one, it's like they just pop up and you don't feel the journey.
I don't know.
And I think that is a big thing. Like I really do feel like that ruins the immersion and the enjoyment because we're not feeling like the dread. We're not feeling the journey. We're not. I don't know. Like everything's too easy and convenient.
Yeah.
It's just bad. Below average, man. Okay, we gave enough time to this.
Yep. Okay. All right, let's move on to... video game music trivia. So I'm going to play you a song. I can give you the year it was released, and you tell me what game you think that's from, Alex. And I'm interested because I think the theme this week is... it's a fun theme, and it has a lot of cool games. So we'll see if you can get the theme that connects all these games together.
Let's do it. I'm confident I'm gonna get it.
All right. Here's the first song. What game is this song from?
Isn't this Zelda?
Going with Zelda?
Legend of Zelda, isn't it? Wait. Yeah, just do it.
Let's see if it's Zelda.
No.
Ooh, no.
I know this. Hold on. What year? I freaking don't.
This came out in 2010.
I feel like I know this.
You definitely do.
Is this Gears of War?
Let's see. No, not Gears of War.
Okay, what is this game?
You're gonna kick yourself.
I know I am, because I know it.
Halo Reach. Close, no.
I knew it too.
Yep. Yeah, that's tough. I had to do the grunt birthday party for Halo Reach. It sounds so different than other Halos, so that's why it's tough, I think.
Yeah, I just.
I get why you guess Zelda, though, because it kind of. The piano sounds like Breath of the Wild-y. Gears of War, you were on the right path with Xbox. Yeah.
Man.
All right.
Okay.
Moving on.
It's okay. I'm going to get all the rest of the other 9 ones.
Okay. Confident. Let's see.
Yep. I'm confident.
What game is this song from?
Is this like Uncharted, maybe?
Let's see if it's Uncharted. No, what, not Uncharted.
What year?
This came out in 2019.
Oh, 2019. Oh, you know what? Is this? Is this Sekiro? Is that how you say it?
Yeah, let's see if it's Sekiro. Yeah, nice.
Yep.
Very nice.
I've only played a little bit of it, but I.
Great music. Great game. Took a long time for this game to click for me, but once it did, man, it's such a good game.
I know, it still hasn't clicked for me yet.
It takes a while. All right, nice. Next one. What game is this song from?
I know this already, and I'm not going to get it out. What year?
This came out in 2011.
This is Zelda, isn't it? Is it Skyward Sword 2011?
Let's see, is it Skyward Sword? Yes, this one is Zelda.
God.
Nice.
I was about to trip myself up because I can't guess Zelda again.
Yep, this is the Lanayru Desert.
Yes, okay.
Very nice. All right. Next one. What game is this song from?
What year is it?
This came out in 2004.
Nothing's popping out right now.
This is kind of a tough one. I know you did play this at least a little bit.
It, Maybe. Is it? The only thing that pops in my head, and I feel like we've had this, and maybe you won't pick it, but maybe you will, because you're going to think I think that. Is it Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic?
Let's see if it's Knights of the Old Republic. No.
Now I'm tripping myself up, because I'm telling me that you would do it, because you think I think that you wouldn't do it, but now you won't do it, because you think that I... Yeah,
I'm in your head.
I don't know, man. I'm just gonna make a random guess. 2004. What was 2004? World of Warcraft. That's fantasy field.
Wow. Very nice. I did not think you were gonna get that one.
That's funny, because like I had a fantasy sound, and I knew World of Warcraft came out 2004, so I just threw that out there.
Very nice, you got it. Yeah, this was the one where I was like, I don't know about this one, if he's going to get it.
That's funny.
Nice putting some clues together, very good. Okay, let's see if you can get this one. What game is this from?
Sounds familiar too. What year is this?
This came out in 1997.
What does this sound like? I feel like I've played this. I feel like I've played this. I recognize this song.
You've definitely played this.
Star Fox? 64?
Let's see if it's Star Fox. I like the guess, but no.
Man, I cannot pinpoint it. I know I've played this song because I can recognize it. Is it... Dude, I swear I recognize this. I feel like I said it all the time, but I really do. I'm going to guess... Oh, you know what? I'm done. Is this Final Fantasy VII? It sounds like Final Fantasy VII.
There you go. Yeah. Yes, I knew you'd get there.
Yeah. I know I recognize. Okay.
This is the Genova theme. Yes.
Yep. And honestly, the do-do-do is what made me recognize it.
Yep, very iconic. Yep. Okay, next up. What game is this song from?
I instantly recognize this too, but I can't pinpoint it. What year?
This came out in 2005.
Is this... Sounds like Kingdom Hearts, maybe? How what would 2005 be? Is that one or two? I think it's two.
Going with Kingdom Hearts 2? Okay, let's see. Wow, you nailed it! It is Kingdom Hearts 2.
Yeah!
Yeah, that game had such good music. I love all the Kingdom Hearts music.
Oh, it's so good. Even, like, especially the opening music
songs or whatever. Uh-huh. Simple and clean. Oh, so good. All right. Next up. What game is this song from?
What, is this Zelda? Breath of the Wild? Or Tears of the Kingdom?
No, it's not.
I had to throw it out there.
I can see it. This came out in 2011.
I definitely recognize this. Is this one Gears of War? I swear Gears of War has piano. Is this Gears of War
3? This is not Gears of War 3.
Gears of War does have some piano songs. So I'm not talking about the main one with...
Not Mad World. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. But yeah, I think it also has some other piano songs, yeah. But no, this is not one of them.
I swear, these days you're going to purposely put a Gears of War piano song in here. That's not Mad World. I'm going to get them wrong.
Let me make a note. Okay, Gears of War, piano.
Not Mad World, because that's too obvious.
Not Mad World. That would be taken down off of YouTube also.
Yeah, really, yeah, that's true. All right. 2011. Man. This is...
I have a hint for you if you need a hint.
Sure.
I'm really surprised this part did not give you PTSD.
Oh, Lord. It sounds so beautiful. Why did it give me PTSD?
Because you probably... I know for a fact you heard it a lot.
Heard it a lot? What is this, like a Souls game? This is Dark Souls?
This is Dark Souls.
Is it really?
Yes.
Why did I not recognize it? Is it because I'm so pissed off I don't think of the music?
This is the one boss you complained to me the most about. Gwyn, Lord of Cinder. The last boss.
The boss where I kept trying to be something I'm not, and I just had to beat myself to beat him.
Yeah, you kept trying to parry him.
Dude, I swear I was looking at this parry and parry him, and I cannot parry. I was trying to be... This is the definition of be yourself. And I swear to God, I played the way I played the whole game. I beat him like in second try.
Yep.
But now you say that, I recognize this stupid song. I actually like it, but
it's such a beautiful song.
It's like there's something about having this for the final boss that's just cool.
Yeah, it is really cool. Oh, it's so beautiful. All right, well, you got that one. I put that in there just for you because I knew that boss pissed you off.
I swear to God, I played that boss like over 2 days, 3 days, like 100 times every day because I was trying to be something I was not. Don't parry if you can't parry. Just beat how you can. I'm proof of it. You don't have to parry.
Or learn to parry before the final boss, I think, is another thing you could do.
Or that. Or be smart and learn, like, probably the best technique for at least for this Souls game. I suck at parrying so much.
You'll get better if you play Sekiro. That's for sure.
I'll have to get better, won't I?
Yeah, it feels a lot better in Sekiro, though. It's way more dynamic.
I will say,
and
I did.
Quick.
Yeah, I will say I did get better at parrying, probably because I had to.
Yeah.
But yeah, practice parrying throughout the game. Don't just dodge. Okay.
Or just dodge and just keep just dodging.
That's true. Yeah, you're right.
That's what I did.
Taking back what I said.
Yeah.
I tried to parry, and guess what? It wasn't me. And so I just dodged and beat him my way. Be yourself. Be yourself.
Yep. There
it's okay. You can do it.
Lessons from gaming.
Today's podcast.
All right. Well, so far you were true. You were telling the truth. You did get all of them right so far after that first one. So let's see if you can keep it up.
That's right. Pressure's on. How many more we got?
Three more.
All right. I got it.
What game is this song from?
What year is this?
This came out in 1999.
What is it about older video game music that just makes me happy?
Yeah, it's so good.
Is it just like the nostalgic feeling?
Doing something with less, like having that restriction, they had to get creative or something, I don't know.
Yeah. Just like that 8-bit type. It's not even 8-bit, but you know what I mean. It's old school, like, it just feels...
like off simpler sound time.
You hit on nail. Just simpler times, simpler style.
Had to come up with creative solutions.
Mm-hmm. It sounds like Donkey Kong. Am I wrong? Right?
Let's see if it's Donkey Kong. No.
It's not a Donkey Kong.
This is a really tough one.
Okay. I can't let our viewers down. I said I was going to get the rest of them.
I don't think you've played this game, but you have played games in the series, and this is one of my favorite games. Probably my second favorite game in the series.
Interesting. Huh. I've played a game in the series.
Yep, probably multiple.
But not this one.
I don't think this one.
That's interesting. I'm trying to think. What vibe is this giving off? Man, I'm not sure. I feel like I've heard it, but I might be, I'm gonna guess, is it a Pokemon game? Sounds like Pokemon. Pokemon.
It is not.
No.
Pokemon.
Okay.
I'll give you a hint, but I think it's too easy, so I won't give you the points. There's another game in this series in this quiz.
In this quiz?
Yes.
Oh, God, I'm having a brain fart now. What games did we have in this quiz, Kayla?
All right, I'm just going to show you.
I don't remember.
Final Fantasy VIII.
Final Fantasy VIII. Is this a good one?
Yeah, this was the first one I played, and I really like it. And then I went back and played 7, and I liked it more. So, but yeah, 8 is good. It's different. There's like a different battle system where they use, like, you don't use MP, you use like AP, and it's a different system of doing it. But I really like it.
I never hear about 8 because everyone talks about 7.
Yeah.
But now that you say that, I can see it being Final Fantasy. The song.
Yeah, it definitely sounds like I could see Donkey Kong. It sounds different than a lot of Final Fantasy
games. I thought like Donkey Kong Country, but I'm like, I don't think a Country game came out in 99.
Yeah.
It kind of has like that atmospheric kind of.
Yep.
At least the beginning. But.
All right. Yeah, that was a tough one. That was the one of the ones I didn't think you were going to get because I know you haven't played it, but.
Yeah.
All right. Two more. What video game is this song from?
Is this Metroid Prime?
It is not Metroid Prime.
What year is this? I feel like I recognize that beginning.
This came out in 2010. Oh, it's so good.
I definitely know this. Come on. Man. Feel like I know this. Is it? Dude, what the heck?
I'm pretty sure you recommended this game to me to get me into this series.
To get you into the series. Wait, is this Xenoblade?
Let's see, is it Xenoblade? Yes! Ah, very nice.
Xenoblade, yes.
Xenoblade Chronicles.
That's right. I forget I recommended this to you, and then you played Xenoblade 2, and I did not like Xenoblade 2 as much as you did.
Oh, I really liked it. It got me hooked. That's
definitely my least favorite.
Interesting. I went back and started playing Xenoblade Chronicles 1 again, because I want to get through the story of that.
Xenoblade Chronicles 1, to me, is the best one. The story is awesome in 1.
I never finished 3 either, but I liked 3 a lot.
I never finished three, but I did. I liked three more than two. It's like if I had to rank them, it'd be 1, 3, and then 2. I wonder what's like the verdict. Like, what do people order rank them? You know, what's the least favorite one? I feel like I hear people like the second one the least favorite.
Yeah, possibly.
A lot. But I mean, they're all good.
Yeah.
I just, for me, the second one was, I don't know. I didn't care for the system as much as that. As yet, the other two, but
yeah, I'm looking.
I feel like most people like the first one the most.
I don't know. I'm saying, I mean, this is just anecdotal, but I'm saying everybody's has a different opinion. Here's Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Here's Xenoblade Chronicles X. Here's Xenoblade 1. Here's Xenoblade 3. Mm. Like, I don't know.
That's how good the series is.
Yeah, it's really good.
That's how good it is. Yeah. So I guess it just depends on your style. I just feel like the second one, well, that had the blade system, right?
Yeah, I really liked the blade system.
See, I wasn't a fan. I loved the system in one. I thought was perfect. Maybe that's why, because I played this one first.
Yeah, that could be.
Maybe it's just, yeah, but they're all good.
Yeah, they're all good. I agree.
I can't wait for Xenoblade X to come out.
Yeah, that's what got me back playing the first one. I'm like, I should go finish those other ones before I get this one.
That's one I have never played.
Yeah, me neither.
So that will be, and I heard it's different, you know, so I'm curious.
Okay.
I need to beat 3.
Yeah,
man, I need to play this game. This is such a good case.
Yeah, they're really fun. All right, last one. What game is this song from?
What year is this?
This came out in 2002. This is also a tough one.
Man. Okay.
When suddenly flamenco guitar.
I was literally just about to say, man, this sounds very like
and then back to like heavy rock.
The only thing, and I'm probably totally off base, but I just started playing it again, and it's a game that you go to different time. Time Splitters 2. I know it came out in 2002. The only reason I know this is because I literally just bought it the other day for like $4. Time Splitters 2.
Let's see if it's Time Splitters 2. Interesting guess. I like that, but nope.
I was just throwing some out of the bag because I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know if you've played this game. I don't. You might have played one of them. You might have actually played
Medal
this one.
Medal of Honor.
Let's see. No.
I'll take one more random guess.
And the Night sounds, of Mayhem. Now, see, now it sounds like points.
Is it Battlefield? Now it sounds like a Battlefield of Medal of Honor target.
No.
Okay.
Okay. The hint is this version of the game had Link in it.
Had Link in it. Soul Calibur? Is it a fighting game?
That is it. It is Soul Calibur, yeah.
That was the one game I played because it had Link.
Yeah. I don't think I'm going to give you the point for that one, but yep.
You don't have to. You don't have to. Yeah.
But you can make up a point because this had a theme. So if you can tell me what the theme of this quiz was, you can get a bonus point. So we can go back and see all the games. So we have Soul Calibur 2, Xenoblade Chronicles, Final Fantasy VIII, Dark Souls, Kingdom Hearts 2, Final Fantasy VII, World of Warcraft, Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, and Halo Reach.
Every main character has a sword. Is that it? Oh, Master Chief. Well, Master Chief gets a sword, doesn't he? From an elite. You can pick up a sword. Yeah, sure, let's guess that. The theme is swords.
I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to give it to you. These are the 10 best video game swords, or the 10 most iconic video game swords, according to GameRant.
Oh, interesting.
Now, I did change a couple, because they had two from Final Fantasy on here, and then they also just had, like, a generic sword, like the King Arthur sword, Excalibur.
Yeah.
So,
do you have it from 1 to 10?
No, but I can...
Or do you know the list?
I can get the list.
I'm curious.
What do you think's number one?
I mean, I'm probably biased, but I feel like Link is the most iconic sword. Link's sword. The Master Sword, but...
Alright, so we'll go 10 down. So 10 is Sekiro, and it's the Mortal Blade. 9 is the Energy Sword from Halo.
Okay.
8 is Frostmourne from Warcraft, so that was the World of Warcraft.
Mm-hmm.
7 is Soul Edge from Soul Calibur, the sword with the eye in it.
Mm-hmm.
6 is Keyblade from Kingdom Hearts. 5 is5 is the Moonlight Sword from the From Software games. So either the Moonlight Greatsword or the Moonlight.
Okay.
It has a few different names. 4 was Masamune, which is from various games. One of them is Final Fantasy VII. I changed that one to Final Fantasy VIII because I really like the Gunblade. So that one, you'll see why I changed it. 3 was Excalibur from various games. They did not have the Monado on there, so I took a liberty and switched that out for the Monado, because the Monado was awesome.
Cool.
Number 2 is Buster Sword from Final Fantasy VII, and number 1, you were correct, is the Master Sword.
Oh, so iconic.
Yep. So
the Buster Sword number 2.
Yep.
Interesting.
You got 8 out of 10 with that extra, the bonus point. Okay. Oh, very nice. You did good.
So I got 1 point back, but I needed to get one more point to stay true to my word.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I guess I said I would get the rest of the answer. I didn't say points.
True. Yeah. I still think 8 out of 10. That's passing. Right? Yeah, that was a fun one to put together.
Yeah, that's passing. I wouldn't get grounded for a B.
Yep.
Even though I'm 30 years old. anyways. I like that. That was cool. Top 10 video game swords. I like that theme.
Yeah. That's a fun one.
It's different. What made you come up with this?
I think I saw a video, a TikTok or something, with some people talking about the best video game swords. I'm like, I wonder if I could use that for a music quiz. So
yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
The Master Sword, man.
Yep, obviously, iconic. Yeah, has to be. I mean, such an iconic sword.
When I think of a sword, like, I always wanted the Master Sword. Always.
Yep. All right. We want to do a Guess the Game?
Let's do it.
All right, Guess the Game. So we're going to be looking at screenshots and trying to figure out what game it is. If we get it in the right series, but not the right game exactly, the number will change to gold, and we'll have 6 chances. So, Alex, any guesses on this one?
I don't know. Mario, Castlevania.
Yeah, I was thinking Castlevania.
With the bricks.
Yeah, let's do, like, Castlevania 2. Let's just see if it's in the series.
Yeah.
It's not. I don't recognize that sprite.
Is this a... I got a game... It was, like, inspired by Castlevania.
Oh.
I forgot what it's called.
What?
It's called. It's probably not even. Oh, Bloodstained? I don't think it's it. You could try Blood.
I've heard of that. Ritual of the Night? Or Curse of the Moon?
Yeah, Ritual of the
Night. Let's see.
Nope.
Ooh,
okay, now.
PC.
I don't know. This now it looks totally different. Now it looks like a tip game.
Yeah, it's like all dark and like spooky.
Well, I guess there's a smile on that thing.
Yeah, that's true.
It's just, I don't know. I'm just straight up some blob things.
I don't know. That slime looks maybe like an old Dragon Quest. I doubt it.
That's a good guess.
But let's just
that's a good guess though.
Dragon. Action adventure compilation puzzle sports 2D scrolling arcade platform shooter. Oh my goodness, what?
Everything you could think of. Action adventure puzzle platformer shooter. This literally it's because it's compilation.
Yeah.
No clue, man. I got nothing.
Are there other micro game games? Because I know let's do Micro Machine. 2024. It's
2020. What the heck? The 2024 PC game, dude? Count me out. This is all you, Caleb.
I don't know it. This is Carnival Mini Mossmouth LLC. Weird. I do not know this.
Me neither.
Moss Mouth. No. Magic Garden, maybe it shows it right there.
Magic, do it.
I don't know. Let's see what this is, because I have no idea. UFO 50.
Interesting.
Interesting. Okay. Well.
Well.
Not a great start.
Not a good start.
Let's see if we can get back on track with this one. Ooh, what is this?
Is that a dam?
Kind of looks like it.
It's 007, Nightfire. You ever play that one?
I might have. Let's try it. Because I do agree it could be a 007 game. Ooh, this looks even more like it could be a 007 game, but...
But, well, no, because it was 007, it would have came yellow.
Yeah, yeah. So it's a 96% on Metacritic. Is that, like, what is that stuff on the wall? Is that, like, zombie goo?
Or is it... Oh, yeah.
Like, or, like, monster...
I'm not.
What's another game around maybe that time?
I mean, you do Perfect Dark. I don't think it's Perfect Dark, but it's around that.
Yeah, let's just see what the next one is. Oh, PC.
Another PC game. I can't do it, Captain.
Could this be like,
So it's some sci-fi game, right? Some like alien,
could this invasion be
type game,
the first
maybe?
Half-Life or something?
Maybe.
Actually, oh, it was! This just reminded me of
that
the head crabs.
That makes sense now. But I've actually never played the first Half-Life.
Yeah, I've only played the second one.
That makes total sense, though.
This looked like it to me. Interesting. Cool.
It looks better than I thought it would.
Actually. Yeah, honestly.
Like, graphics-wise.
Yeah. Who pulled that out of nowhere, thank goodness. All right, we've got a destroyed office area.
Is that one of these simulation games or something?
Maybe, but it looks like there's blood going on over here.
But is it what's that game where like when you shoot it's slow motion until you
super hot?
Yeah.
I could with the destruction, I could see that. Ooh, nope. Huh. 75%. Could this be, this reminds me of like, what is it? Crackdown? Like that logo or something. Something about this. Although that's more future-y, isn't it?
Crackdown. There's a lot of glowiness in Crackdown. At least Crackdown 3. Maybe like the first or second Crackdown.
Yeah, let's try 2, because it looks a little newer-ish. Okay, PC, PS5, Xbox Series. So it's new.
Interesting.
What about I was going to say one of the newer Watch Dogs or something, but it doesn't look hecky enough.
That just looks so much different than like this.
Yeah. This honestly, like with the destruction, it kind of reminded me of what I've played of Control, because you can like really mess stuff up, but I don't.
That definitely doesn't. I don't think that's Control.
Yeah, that gun doesn't look like it'd be. About Redfall.
I feel like that's always a good guess. We don't know shooter.
First person shooter. Focus 15%.
I do not recognize this upgrade system.
Yeah, me neither.
But it's a newer game. What's a newer shooter that's come out? Or at least on the system?
Huh.
Ooh. I'm trying to think. A first person shooter. It's only on PS5 and PC and Xbox Series.
Yeah. So
current gen.
What about no, it wouldn't be The Division. It looks like it could be first person.
Maybe I definitely don't recognize the upgrade system.
Yeah.
Maybe. What's that game that. Is it a Metro game, maybe?
It's the newest one.
Metro, like, I think Exodus.
I'm good throwing that out and seeing the next one.
Yeah.
2023.
2023. Okay, so that's what, last year?
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? You know what this looks like? I wanted to get this game. Is it RoboCop?
Oh.
This game, RoboCop Rogue City. I've heard great things about this game, actually.
Interesting. You know what it looks like? Let's see. Oh, very nice. Yeah. Oh, and we reached a new rank.
Oh, sweet. Yeah, I've actually heard really good things about this game.
Interesting. I don't think I've even seen this game.
Yeah, it got, for what it is, it got like really, really decent reviews.
Huh. Well, very nice. Good job.
Yes. I knew my pointless review watching of games I never buy will come in handy.
That's funny. This is a Monkey Island game. No.
Nah, that was a good guess.
Platformer, maybe? Could this be a Sonic? I don't recognize those, though.
I don't. Maybe.
It's not. It's for PC and Macintosh.
Macintosh. And one of those bats?
Yeah.
Maybe. Are they in a cave? Cave some. Cave dwellers.
Cave digger. The cave.
Cave noir.
Caveman tales. Adventure Indian platform.
I don't know.
Huh. It's not this, but let's just see what the next one is. 2005. Is that a goldfish with a gun?
That's great. Goldfish gun. Fish gun.
Fish gun. Gold fever. Fish gun. No.
Oh, I was hoping there would be a game called that. And is that a fish fishing?
Or is it a rabbit? I don't know. I can't tell.
You're right. That might be a rabbit fishing and a fish with a gun.
Let's see what the last one is.
Dusk Diver.
Studio Pixel. Nickel.
It looks interesting.
Huh. Yeah, I've definitely never played.
I don't know. Gadget Boy.
Pixel. Because it's Pixel, Studio Pixel. So.
Pixel. Is there a Pixel Boy?
Pixel.
A Pixel Story.
Pixel Noir. Cave Story. Cave. You actually almost had it.
We should have did the most basic thought process, man. We should have been like cavemen.
Oh, man, that's funny.
You literally should have just done something stupid like that. Cave Dang Story. It. The funny thing is we were doing stupid stuff, just not with a cave.
Yeah. What is All this? Right.
This is Final Fantasy.
Which one?
I just saw a light and I saw graphics that kind of look
like... It looks to me... Maybe this is... Oh, it looks like an exit sign or something. Maybe this is a Metro. What's like an old Metro?
Their names, I don't know which one's old and which one's not.
So. Yeah, let's just see.
What about Mini Metro?
It's older than that. This looks pretty old.
Maybe this could be like the first Far Cry game.
Mm.
You ever play Far Cry 1?
I think I've only played 2 and on. I don't think I played the first one. PS2. Is this an old...
So PS2, what is it? Shoot?
Metal Gear Solid, maybe? No.
Oh, that's
maybe? I don't know.
Maybe that could, no, that could be. That, is that Snake's leg?
I don't know. Did the ammo ever look like this, though? I don't know. I haven't played those many of those.
It could be Twin Snakes, actually. That's the remake up from the GameCube.
Okay, let's see. No.
Nope. That was a decent guess. Oh, wait. PS2 third person.
Is this? Not this Team is a Fortress, is it? I've only seen 2. Team Fortress 2.
I guess you go.
What's that?
There's a game I played. There's a game I played, and I don't even think you've probably ever heard of it. And I never thought I'd ever bring this game up again. It's called...
Hit Me With It.
Played with Lawrence. Logan's Shadow.
Siphon Filter Logan's Shadow?
Yes.
I've actually heard of that.
Oh, you have?
No.
Darn it, I swear it looked like it.
I think I used to see it in Blockbuster, but I never got it.
No, probably.
What is going on here?
Man, that was my Hail Mary. Maybe. Hmm.
2000 PS2 third-person shooter. Third-person shooter. It looks like everything's in first. Well, I guess we don't.
Interesting. I'm trying to think of a third-person shooter on PS2.
Could this be a 007?
Was that exclusive to PS2?
I don't know. One of them might have been.
That's true. Yeah, you might as well guess it.
Okay, it's not. Oh.
Like, really?
Huh.
I'm not sure I know this one.
Have no idea.
Just, I guess we could just take guesses. I don't even know.
Trying
to think of a game I could even guess for the PS2. I don't know, is it just some random Splinter Cell game? Some old Splinter Cell Tom... Oh, no. Well, maybe. Ask, I don't know.
Just
normally, makes...
Yeah. I have no idea. This is... I don't know. X-Squad. I've never heard of that.
I haven't either.
Weird.
X-Squad, is that like DC?
Oh, maybe.
Doesn't DC have an X-Squad? I feel like I've heard of like the X...
I've heard of X-Force.
I've never heard of that game either.
Huh, no.
X-Squad, no.
Just the game. What I come up with?
Yeah.
Interesting.
I've honestly never heard of that either.
Yeah, weird. Ooh, what is this?
What was that? Dragon Age?
Maybe. I mean, it looks more like it would be Veilguard, if anything, but... We can do, like, Dragon Age Inquisition. Yeah, with these graphics, I don't think that was a bad guess.
That's a dragon thing, right?
Or a griffin or something.
Yeah, something.
Could this be, like, the new dragon... Dogma?
That's what I was thinking, too. Or at least even the first one. First one looks pretty good. Dark Horizon.
Yeah, we can try it. Nope. PS5, PC, Xbox Series.
Is this that Lords of the Fallen, maybe?
Oh, maybe.
We haven't played it, but I feel like this is the style.
Yeah. Let's see. Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
Good job. Yeah, that'd be one I kind of want to try.
Yeah, I've heard mixed things, but like Dalen played it. He said he loved it.
Yeah, and I'm sure it's gotten better. He's into the Soul
games.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I think they have like a new version. Because every time I look at it, it's like Lords of the Fallen 2.0 or 1 point something. Yeah.
Okay.
I think they've definitely changed a lot since it first came.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's hard to tell what's going on here, honestly.
That almost looks like, have we had it before? Okami? Have you heard of that one?
Yeah. I don't think we've had it. I'm good trying Okami.
It has the art style just from this little thing looks.
Yeah.
Nope. That zero looks
familiar. Yeah, this does look familiar. Is this a mobile game? Wait, is this Fire Emblem Heroes? No way, right? It is. I played this game so much when it first came out. Oh, that's funny.
Nice. Nice. We got a mobile game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do play mobile games, so. Oh, yeah. This actually, I recognize this now. It was the Zero. You were right. The Zero and this character, because the character style is.
Yeah, that Zero stood out to me, because I played this when it first came out, too. And that Zero looked familiar.
Yeah. Nice.
Far Cry.
Or Dead Island, or.
Yeah, or Dead Island. Or.
I'm good. There's so many Far Cries. Let's throw out like Far Cry 6 and see.
Yeah.
Ooh, is it a racing
you know what
game?
This could be? What's that? I think it's. What's that zombie game that's on the PlayStation? That's exclusive to PlayStation. It's called. It's actually a good game.
I know which one you're talking about. Dying Light.
Not Dying Light.
It's something like that, though.
Yeah, it's Jesus Christ. I was just thinking about this game the other day.
Is it Days Gone or something? Or
Days Gone. I think. Yeah, I think it's Days Gone. Let me. I'm gonna. Let's go and see.
And I'm good to try that one.
Yes, it's Days Gone. Is the one I'm thinking.
All right, let's see. No.
No. Oh, that worked for that. PC. So a last gen game.
Is this like Cabela's Big Game Hunt or something? This could be a hunter's thing.
What is? Oh wait, is that it? That's like a deer. Dude, you should just do it. Just do the Cabela's Big Hunter.
Hunting party. Oh, it is a shooter simulation sports. Don't they have like a bass? Oh yeah, that's fishing. Hunter simulator.
I don't know what other hunting simulators are there. Monster Hunter.
Quest Hunter. Big Buck Hunter.
All I know is the Cabela's. Did you do was Cabela one you guessed?
Yeah, unless like different Cabela's have a different.
2011, was that last gen?
Or 2017.
Oh, look at it. Just type in Cabela 2017.
Honestly, no. Cabela's Dangerous Hunts. Expansive Worlds AB.
What about, what was that game called? The Hunter or something? Or Way of the Hunter? I think it might just be called The Hunter.
The Hunter Call of the Wild?
Sure.
Sure. Oh, it was! Oh, man. Very nice.
I was not confident in that.
Nope. I really was hoping we'd get Cabela's on this one.
That would have been hilarious. Do people play these games?
They must.
Because what is that? Super Mario Wonder? It's one of the first games.
Actually, not. Yeah, could be. And this will be our last one.
Probably not, but.
Oh, what a guess, dude.
Oh, wow. I loved that game.
Yeah, that game is great. I don't think I ever beat it, but I can't believe you got it from this.
I don't know. There's something about it. It just seemed like that game.
Yeah, man. I see it. Like, when you said it, I was like, yeah, that could be. Yep.
I'm going to predict the Chargers win right now, Caleb. Okay? All Chargers right. Are going to win tonight.
Cool. I sure hope so.
It happened. It is because I said so.
Yeah, you're psychic. Yeah. Okay, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, I guess
not our best one.
We only did 9. Let's do one more just for to see if we can get one more, even though that was a really good one to leave off on. So I might
know, that's a good one to add on, but eh.
I could always cut this out later.
Dark Souls. I didn't see a lamp.
Is that like through glass or something?
I know. I was trying to figure out. Let's do it.
Witcher 2. No. What the heck? Whoa.
Yeah, this is some weird.
Could this be. Game. What is that? Senua's Sacrifice or something? It does really weird. Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. Hellblade? Oh, it does some weird stuff. Oh, nice!
Yeah!
I did not think that was going to be it.
We're ending on the last two.
Yes, that was good. That's a good place to end it. Thanks, everyone. And we will play this again next week.
Oh, man, that was great.
I cannot believe we got those last two that fast.
I know. That's perfect last ones.
So I've been playing Diablo now. My wife finally got into it, so
what build are you?
I'm doing Spiritborn, the Rebounding Feather, the feathers.
Ooh,
one.
Okay. Also, she let you be Spiritborn.
Yeah, she tried it too and didn't like it, so she's being a sorceress and I'm being Spiritborn.
Okay. I still haven't beaten the campaign.
We haven't either. We got to level 60 and I think I'm level 40 Paragon and she's level like 70 Paragon, or I might be 50 Paragon.
Yeah.
Quillvolley.
I'm the Quillvolley one. Yeah, that's the one I'm doing too. Yeah.
It's really strong. Like, mm-hmm. I'm having a lot of fun with it. But yeah, we're like...
Yeah, it's fun.
I don't think we're super far in the campaign, but we could probably just bum rush and beat it, but we've just been doing other stuff.
Oh, yeah. And I never opened up the map fully, so, like, I finally did all that. I did all I did all the, I was just doing a bunch of side stuff, pretty much.
Yeah, we've been doing, like, Nightmare Dungeons.
But it's fun.
And stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun.
The game is freaking addicting.
Yeah, it's very addictive.
I think that's, like, that's the thing with Diablo. It's just so addicting to me. There's something about the gameplay. You just, like, throw it on and you just freaking play. I would play and watch football with it, like, pretty much every Sunday.
That's a good...
Well, like, not if the Cardinals are on, but you know what I mean.
Every commercial, just keep going in a dungeon or something, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or even like the Cardinals aren't playing, I have Red Zone on, and just play this and like just watch unlimited football for 5 hours.
Nice,
life. Yeah, it's fun. I like it. And the campaign, like you said, I haven't beat it, but it's a Diablo campaign. I actually really liked the story of the base campaign a lot.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
I liked it. I liked. But yeah, I haven't.
Yeah, we still need to also. We've been enjoying it.
I actually beat the Black Ops 6 campaign.
Oh, nice. How is it? And I haven't even tried it yet.
That was probably the best Call of Duty campaign I played in forever. Like a long time. It was you would like it. And I think what makes it good, it's like a 10-hour campaign, so it's a good chunk. But I think what makes it good is, number one, the story is good and the characters are good. Like, and you have like a base you go to after every mission where you can like upgrade your weapons and find like hidden secrets at your base. So it has like a little bit of RPG elements. I mean, very slight, like you just upgrade weapons and perks and stuff. And then what the other thing I like about it is each level is different. It's not just run and gun explosion. Like one, well, not spoiling anything, like one mission, you know, you're in a casino and it feels like you're doing like an Ocean 11 type
thing.
And another, yeah, and then like the next mission, you're like at some abandoned like science lab facility, and it has like a horror theme to it, so it's like a horror game for a freaking thing.
Yeah,
they kind of bring zombies type, you know, feel to the campaign. Not saying like actual zombies, but
that feel. Yeah.
Yeah, and then like another, you're like, invading. It does have the. It's an open world. You're in Iraq, and it's like open worlds. Like you could do
Oh.
side missions and stuff. So like
Wow.
it has a bunch of different style levels, which makes it my problem with the Black Ops or not Black Call of Duty campaigns, where it was always just like I would get bored of it because it just seems like run, shoot, go to this location, run, shoot, go to this location.
Yeah.
And this one, it doesn't do that as much. It breaks it up. I think you would actually really like this campaign. I'm not kidding.
Yeah, I'll probably give it a try.
And it's only, 8 to 10 hours. It's not like you'd be spending a whole freaking
Right. I could
week
blow
on.
through that. Yeah. Get through it
Yeah,
real quick.
it's like do one mission here, one mission there. I really enjoyed it. And I've been playing multiplayer, and it's Call of Duty. I mean,
Yeah.
I said I wasn't gonna buy it, but I don't know what it is, man. I think I have an addiction to just Call of Duty.
Yeah, I get
I
it.
play it for it's like a maybe it's because it's winter out here and it's cold and I can't do anything else, but like I always play Call of Duty throughout the winter and then come springtime and summer, like I never played it.
Yeah, me too. Nowadays.
But yeah, but I do have more like my friend some friends out here got it and are playing it, and then me and you could play it,
Yeah, I
so
need to
like I do have
download
more
it.
people that could play that, but I it's as far as like Call of Duty game, it's definitely one of the better ones recently,
Yeah, that's cool. I'm excited to try the campaign. Like,
yeah.
you've
And
sold it to me.
yeah, it's good. I mean, like I said, it's not gonna like blow you away like, oh my God, this is the best thing ever, but like
Sure.
it reminds me of the old school like Call of Duty campaign,
Yeah, that's cool.
that were actually good. And one other I did buy it was on sale for like $6, and I loved this game as a kid, the Pac-Man Worlds re-rec or whatever. The remake of the Pac-Man World game. You ever played that?
I don't think I have. Let me look it up.
No. Well, I played a lot more Pac-Man World 2, but I loved these
Interesting.
games as a kid. It's basically like a 3D version
Yeah.
of Pac-Man.
For some reason, it
It was
reminds
like on
me of
sale for six.
Glover. I don't know if you ever played Glover, but
I did.
interesting. That's on the
Like, did you ever
PlayStation?
play? Yeah, PS5.
Maybe I'll try it.
It's like a little 3D platformer type. I loved it as a kid, dude. It was
Yeah.
so I'm just hoping it gets in. It was like on sale for $7 instead of 30. So like, okay.
Nice, yeah.
I played the second one the most, but this was a remake of the first. It's kind of like a. Have you ever played Warrior World? I used to love that as a kid too.
I think we've talked about this, and I always think I have, but I've played a different Warrior. Yeah, no, I don't think I've played this. I know I've seen it.
Oh, it's so fun. I remember I rented this from Blockbuster and I had it for the weekend, and they're like, it's like a you had to collect a lot of things, and I was trying
Yeah.
so hard one weekend just to freaking
Get
collect
everything.
everything in this game.
Oh yeah,
Oh,
'cause
the good
you
old
couldn't like keep
Blockbuster
your
days.
save, huh? Like it would, or was this on GameCube, so you probably could
This was
save
GameCube.
it. Okay, yeah.
You could, I just know I wouldn't be able to like they my parents wouldn't
Yeah.
like I couldn't you like renew it or something? I
I
don't
think
remember. Or
so.
no, or if there's like another copy. I don't know. All I know is I just my parents said I'd return it by Monday, so or
Yep.
Tuesday. And but it was another game I did like. Have you ever heard Attack and the Power of Juju? I feel like no one's ever heard of this game.
Yeah, I used to play that.
Yeah. Oh, you
Yep.
did? Okay.
I
Like these
played it
games,
on
these were games
GameCube.
I would rent. Yeah, I played on
Yeah.
GameCube too. I would
I think
rent
I
these from
owned it.
Blockbuster, and I think I owned one of them. I did not own the second one, or
I think I only ever
I
played the
owned the
first one.
first one. But no one ever talks about these games, and I used to love these stupid games.
Yeah. They were pretty fun, yeah.
I didn't even know it was Nickelodeon, to be quite honest.
Yeah, me neither. There's one
I just played it.
that I have that's like that, and it's Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg.
I have not played
It's a weird game, but it was pretty fun. Or
this.
Glover, like I said, Glover
You
is
played
really
on the
fun.
GameCube too?
Yeah. For Nintendo 64, it was Glover. This game was fun. It was hard, but it was fun.
I haven't played. Oh no, I play. I no. Maybe I've just heard of it. I don't think I've actually played it.
Pretty good game.
Donald Glover.
I've been trying out Nier Automata. And that's been really fun. Oh, yeah,
that one's fun.
I've really liked it. I'm probably like 10 hours in.
Yeah, that one's... I love the atmosphere in it.
Yeah, it's really cool. The story's really interesting. The sets. Mm-hmm. Like, how far have you gotten in this game?
I was about 10 hours, too.
Okay, so did you get to the, like, carnival thing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was cool.
That part was really interesting, really cool.
Yeah, I like that. Different. It's crazy when you play this how much you can see Stellar Blades inspired by
it. I know, it really is. Yep, I was thinking that the whole time. So yeah, that's been fun.
The other game I've been playing still is the Ys 10.
Oh yeah, I started Ys 9 just a little bit to get into to see. Yeah, I might play that after Nier. But there's so many games.
Yeah, it's fun. There's so many games. I mean, I've even slowed down on Ys 10, but it's something about the Ys. Ys games are so like there's kind of like a they're simple, but they're so fun.
Yeah. They are really fun.
And then I want to get a... There was a game. Hopefully, I mean, I know Black Friday will have a ton of sales, so I'll probably pick up a couple games on Friday.
Yeah.
Like digital. I'll do it digital.
Mm-hmm.
I like doing... Number one, digital is easier. And number two, I like we could share. Let's do it.
Yeah, that's true.
there was one.
I want to get Metaphor, Fantasero, maybe Black Myth Kong. Dragon Age Veilguard. There's a lot of games I want.
Oh yeah, I was going to ask you about that because I've heard so many mixed things about that game, Dragon Age.
Yeah, I'll definitely play it someday, probably when it goes on sale. It looks interesting. Like, I feel like they've Inquisition wasn't my favorite, but it was still good and the story was good. Like, I feel like Origins is the best, and then maybe Inquisition or two, and then we'll see about Veilguard.
Yeah, I've never, like I said, I've never really played Dragon Age. I think I dabbled into Inquisition, but I don't think I played enough to even really remember.
Yeah. Yeah, it's very similar to, like, Mass Effect and Baldur's Gate.
Okay. Well, as good?
Some of them.
Okay.
I think. I really liked Origins from what it was a long time ago, so it might not hold up as much, but man, it was so good at the time.
Yeah. Hmm. I know there's a. This is another Monster Hunter game, Wilds, coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And we've talked about it. Like, I love Monster Hunter, but if it's one of those things where I don't get into it, it's very hard to play.
I've never been able to get into it. I tried recently with the Rise that just came out on the PlayStation, and I just could not get into it.
Yeah, I know, and like I can't. Like I actually like Rise. I played Rise on Switch a while back, and I liked it, but like I stopped playing it, and like you know, once you stop playing that kind of game, it's
hard to go back.
Just jump, yeah. So yeah. I'm iffy on. The new Monster Hunter. I really want to get Lies of P, like, but it's not on sale right now.
Yeah.
If it was on sale, I was going to buy that because I'm kind of getting that
soul's itch.
I am, and I need to beat 2, but I've been dying to play Lies of P. I just love the idea of that atmosphere.
Yeah, it's really good.
So I know you could play that on Xbox, but I don't have Xbox.
Yeah.
So if that goes on sale, I'll probably... But you've already played that, though, so...
I have.
Although maybe you'll play it again. Who knows?
I might if you get it. Honestly, I was just thinking about it.
You're like, yeah, maybe.
Well, if you twist my arm.
But, yeah, you have to play it. But yeah, that's pretty much all I've been playing. Just, honestly, Call of Duty and E. That's...
Yep.
I'm trying to think. That's really all I've been playing. And watching Rings of Power is kind of all I've been watching. Oh, this weekend, Gladiator comes out.
Ooh, I do want to see that.
Talk about...
Yes.
So I'm going Friday morning.
Okay.
To see it. So if we want to talk about it Sunday.
Cool. Yeah. I'll see it this weekend. Yeah. That looks interesting.
I think the Wicked movie comes out this weekend too, but I mean, I don't know if I'll have time for both.
Yeah. I probably won't.
If you wanted to see Wicked.
I do kind of, cause I've seen that live in London. So I wouldn't mind seeing that.
Maybe that's something we could see the next week.
Yeah. I think that's a good plan.
Yeah. Cause, and I think that movie is like a 3-hour movie.
Oh, dang. Yeah.
I think I'm going to look right now.
That would make sense with the musical.
And it's only like a part one, not a part two.
Oh, really? That I didn't know.
So it's 2 hours and 45 minutes, almost 3 hours.
Okay. Yeah.
Cause I don't think anything comes out. Oh, you know what? That's Thanksgiving weekend, Holly. I might have to skip that.
Yeah, true. I'll be at my mom's. Yeah.
Either or, we can watch it at some point.
Yeah.
Before the podcast. After, yeah. Well, actually, yeah. I guess we could.
We'll figure it
do
out.
Do that.
Yeah.
And I'm going to see Moana Thanksgiving weekend, so I can talk about it. You don't have to see that one, but I can talk about it.
I mean, I liked the first Moana, but yeah, I probably won't go see it in theaters.
Yeah. Well, I have an excuse with kids.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah, that's pretty much all I've done.
Yeah, I think that's everything. So thanks, everyone, for joining us, and we will talk to you again next week.
Peace.